Captions in English, please. So this is the third video on chapter 3, and this video will focus on classification of matter. So matter can be classified into pure substances or mixture. So pure substances are composed of one type of atom or one type of compound. And so you can give it a formula. Whenever you have a pure substance, you can give it a formula. And so that's because the composition does not vary. For example, water is always H2O, and hydrogen, the gas, is H2, and argon is Ar. Carbon dioxide is CO2. So each of these are examples of atoms, you know, single atoms like argon, or compounds like water and carbon dioxide. Mixtures are when you have two or more types of atoms or compounds mixed together. So basically it's when you have pure substances, at least two pure substances together, then they form a mixture. So it can be a mixture of elements, or a mixture of compounds, or a mixture of elements and compounds together. And so the composition varies. So you can have more or less of one compound versus the other. So you cannot give a formula to a mixture. You can only give the formula of the pure substances that compose the mixture. But after that, it's, you know, proportions or percentages for each of them. You cannot give a formula, a specific formula for a mixture. For example, salt water. So you have salt, which is a pure substance, and water, another pure substance, both a compound. And so when you mix them together, you get salt water, and that's a mixture. Soda usually is based on water. So water is the solvent. And then typically there is a sugar and other molecules that give a different taste. So it's also a mixture. Concrete is a mixture of different compounds as well. So let's talk about what is a molecule versus a compound, because the confusion is easily done. A compound is a substance that contains two or more different elements combined in the fixed ratio. For example, water is a compound made of two hydrogens and one oxygen, so of formula H2O. Carbon dioxide is made of one carbon and two oxygen, so the formula is CO2. Potassium bromide is KBr, made of potassium and bromine together. So all of these are compounds because they are made of two elements of different types set into a specific formula. So fixed ratio here refers to the fact that there is a formula, and it's always the same formula for a given compound. A molecule is formed when two or more atoms, and that's where is the difference. It can be the same type of atoms together, or different elements together. That are bound together. So compounds can be molecules. For example, water, carbon dioxide, so H2O and CO2 are molecules as well as compounds. But H2 is a molecule, but it's made of two hydrogen atoms. So that means it's not a compound. N2 is made of two nitrogen atoms. It's a molecule because it's made of two atoms. But it's not a compound because it's two atoms of the same kind. Same with sulfur 8 or phosphorus 4. They are made of more than one atom, so they are molecules. But sulfur 8 and phosphorus 4 are both not a compound because they are made of the same type of atom. So we would call them elements. The illustration here to the right shows you examples of ozone of formula O3. It's a molecule because it's made of at least two atoms, and here three atoms bonded together. So it's a molecule, but it's not a compound because the three atoms are of the same kind. So it's going to be an element. Water, the example of water, is a molecule and a compound at the same time. So it's a molecule because it's of three atoms bonded together. And it's a compound because there is two kinds of atom, hydrogen and oxygen. So elements, so pure substances can be classified into compounds or elements. And so elements are given in the table, periodic table of the elements. So if you are wondering, is this an element? You look at the periodic table, and if it's listed there, then it's an element. It's all the elements that exist and that have been discovered up to now. Another table of the elements here that are listed in alphabetic order. Notice how the seven diatomic elements, you know, some of them are not included. And for example, hydrogen here should be after holmium and before indium, but it's not included. The reason why I put H2, it's because hydrogen, when you find it in nature, is the gas H2, made of two atoms of hydrogen. Nitrogen here should be here between niobium and nobelium. N2, made of two atoms of nitrogen, is an element. Oxygen, another element made of two oxygens. Fluorine, F2, and chlorine, Cl2, are not included. However, out of those seven diatomic molecules that are elements, so diatomic means molecules, means molecules made of two atoms of the same kind here. And so because it's atoms of the same kind, then they are considered elements. But here, bromine is included and iodine is also included. I'm not sure why these two are included, but not the others. Anyway, all of these are the seven diatomic elements, which are found as, you know, diatomic molecules. So as I alluded already, a pure substance can be further classified as an element or a compound. And so when a pure substance is an element, elements are substances that cannot be broken down into simpler substances. You cannot make them something else that is smaller or simpler. They are composed of only one type of atom, and examples are oxygen, helium, aluminum, and so note how oxygen here is a diatomic molecule found as O2 in nature, as opposed to helium, which is just atoms of helium by themselves, or aluminum, a metal, which is only aluminum atoms, you know, packed together because it's a solid. And a pure substance can also be a compound, and a compound will be composed of two or more different elements. So you can give it a formula, and it has to have at least two different elements in that formula. For example, carbon dioxide, CO2, is a compound, and it has this set formula, CO2. And sucrose, the table sugar, is also of C12H22O11. It's not written there, but it's made of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And so, because you can give it a precise and set formula, it's a compound. So mixtures can also be further classified into homogeneous mixture or heterogeneous mixtures. So homogeneous, homo means the same. So a mixture that is homogeneous, it's because it looks the same throughout. So it's the same composition throughout. You cannot tell that it's a mixture. Well, by looking at it, it looks like one thing. However, you know it's made of more than one substance. For example, coffee, we know it's not just water, it's water with caffeine and maybe other molecules in there. So we know it's made of more than one substance, but it looks like one black liquid. Air is an homogeneous mixture. It's a mixture of different gases. And the two main ones are nitrogen and oxygen. Soda is an homogeneous mixture made of principally water as the solvent, and then sugar and other molecules in there. But when you look at the soda, it may look like water. Steel, there's a picture just below showing some lines here of steel. It's an alloy made of principal element is iron and then some carbon. Carbon is infused into it to make it stronger and so that it rusts less. And steel can also have, you know, iron, carbon, and other metals, or else to improve the properties of iron, which is the main element in steel. But still, you know, if you look at it, it looks like one metal, and you cannot tell that it's actually made of more than one type of atom. Wine is another example where you have water, alcohol, and probably other molecules. Vinegar, again, a solution of water and acetic acid, which is vinegar. So that's examples of homogeneous mixtures that look like one substance, but we know it's made of more than one substance. And then heterogeneous mixtures, that they are the easiest to see because their composition varies from one region to another. Visually, you can tell that it's made of more than one substance. You can see the different parts in it. So it's very easy to classify a mixture as heterogeneous. For example, wet sand, you know, you see the sand, you know it's wet, there's some water. You can distinguish the water from the sand. Concrete, looking at it, you see different pieces or different stone colors and textures. And so it's obvious it's not homogeneous. Soil, you know, that you find on the ground is another example of heterogeneous mixture, or a bowl of mixed M&Ms. Just the colors tell you that there's more than one substance there. So overall, matter can be classified as pure substances or mixtures. When you have a pure substance, you can further classify it as element or compound. The example for element here is copper tubes. And copper is made of just single atoms of copper. But remember how elements can also be the seven diatomic molecules that are hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Pure substances can be compounds if they have two elements at least bonded together in a set ratio. So it can be more than two elements, but it needs to be at least two different elements bonded together. Matter can be classified as mixture, and in this case you can classify it as homogeneous or heterogeneous depending on if you can see the different parts in the mixture or if it looks like one substance. So let's see if you can apply that knowledge and classify each of the following as pure substance or mixture. So if you decide it's a pure substance, classify the pure substance as element or compound. And if you decide it's a mixture, classify it as homogeneous or heterogeneous. So remember to pause the video before you watch the answer so that you work this out on your own before. This is the best way to learn. So lead fishing weight, is this a pure substance or mixture? This is actually made of just lead. And so lead is actually an element. If you look at the periodic table, you will find lead. And the symbol is Pb. So the lead fishing weight is a pure substance and an element, and we can give it its symbol Pb. Distilled water, is it a pure substance or mixture? So distilled water is water that you obtain by evaporating the water and then recovering the water. So it's purified and it's made to remove all the ions from it. So then that sounds like a pure substance, right? Pure substance. Now, is it an element or a compound? Water, we know, has a formula H2O. So that's a compound. It's made of two different elements bonded together in a set ratio. Italian salad dressing. That's, if you look at it, you can tell it's made of different things, right? If you let it sit, usually there's some decanting happening. The oil moves up, the vinegar moves down. So that's a mixture, and it's a heterogeneous mixture. It doesn't mix very well. Mercury in a thermometer. So mercury, you will find it in the periodic table. It's that only metal that is liquid at room temperature. So that's an element, which means it's a pure substance. And the symbol is Hg. Exhaled air. So the air you exhale when you breathe out. So we know when we breathe out, we breathe air, but also carbon dioxide in it. So air is made of mainly nitrogen and oxygen. So that tells you there's more than one thing in there. So we have a mixture here. However, when you exhale air, you know, it looks like, it doesn't look like anything actually, but it could be one gas, it could be several gases, you cannot tell. So it looks homogeneous. So it's a homogeneous mixture. The minestrone soup, that's the Italian soup made of, you know, tomatoes, some vegetables, maybe white beans and pasta. So you can definitely tell the different parts. And so that's a heterogeneous mixture. Salt, salt, maybe you don't know yet, but you will learn this definitely. Salt has a formula NaCl. It's made of sodium and chlorine. So we call it sodium chloride. It's then a compound because we can give it its formula NaCl. It's always one sodium for per chlorine. You know, it's forming an ionic compound and it's a pure substance.